My name is Kumi Rattenbury and I'm an ecologist. I work for the Park Service in Fairbanks, Alaska. And mostly I do large mammal research up in the parks north of town, Gates of the Arctic, Noatak, Kowuk Valley, Cape Krusenstern, and Bering Land Bridge.
One of the park archaeologists,
Joe Keeney, approached me and Marcy, our subsistence coordinator, and asked if there was a way to get a caribou skeleton or sheep skeleton into the collections, an entire skeleton, so that they could compare it with archaeological artifacts that they're picking up at Matcharak and other sites in the upper Noatak River Valley. So they wanted to compare bones or bone fragments that they found to identify what sort of animals people were eating out there and maybe learn a little bit about hunting practices. So we wanted to work with the community of Anaktuvuk Pass to also make it an educational program.
I'm Sue McCullough. I'm the Early College Coordinator here at Effie Kokrine Early College Charter School, and I work for the University of Alaska Fairbanks. My involvement, I was contacted by Kumi and Marcy from National Park Service, our neighbors here at Effie Kokrine, to find students who would be interested in going to Anaktuvuk Pass.
My name is Sulemi Juarez. I go to Effie Kokrine. Sue McCullough from my college coordinator. She usually just offers me opportunities to go to trips to different places if it involves with archaeology or anything that involves with my college interest.
So then some of the high school students from Anaktuvuk Pass and also the students that traveled with us from Effie Kokrine, they sat down with Rachel Riley, who's an elder in the community. She's also on the Gates of the Arctic Subsistence Resource Commission, and they butchered a caribou skeleton from start to finish.
I think it was really good for the kids because some of the teachers brought their kids to the home ec and they were really interested in watching the caribou get cut up, because some of the kids actually have never seen a caribou being butchered or people cutting it up and stuff like that, and I think that was really good for them.
We're taking the meats off and for the park service. So tune and teach your words often.
Yep.
There's knives over there. What do we do before we do it? Wash our hands.
I think we all learn a little bit as every time we cut or like butcher a caribou, we just learn at least something, that they tell us what to do, and we'll remember it. It's truly a different food than anything else. I feel like it provides for my soul and makes me strong.
How does the meat taste?
Tastes great. We always do that outside, just share it. The fat is called kauna, and the meat is tutukopepe. And we eat it raw too. We also dry them. Well, that's what a lot of people here does because it tastes so good. It's called bunnik. And the one in the bone, inside the marrow, is called bunnik. It's really good.
We had the opportunity to help elders there too.
Oh, Rachel Riley, man, I could work that lady all day long. She's amazing. She was an amazing elder. She's really knowledgeable and she was good with the students.
Sisoalik was one of the greatest persons I know. And the elder, who are the elders now? Because she's a great teacher. She knew everyone. She really opened it up. And she wanted us to learn. And I'm great for that.
Can we
take off stuff like this little bit of fat, or can I put tissue
to go in and taste it? There's a bone marrow right there. You
slide. Should I flip it?
Yeah.
Not that necessary. She taught us, she told me how to use the ulu, so that is me, it's incredible.
I found it really interesting when she turned to Sulaimi and realized she was struggling with that knife, because she gave those girls a really delicate task. She handed her that ulu, and Sulaimi had been watching her use that ulu, she just picked it up. Rachel's, you know, just kind of handing it over to her, like, here is a better tool. Use this tool, that'll go much quicker. Let me see, and she was able to whip off all those little caribou ankles.
In the cooking class, they got together and made a big stew from the caribou meat, and they also got to make donuts with another one of the elders in town, and that was served at school lunch one of the days, and then the rest of the meat was donated to different people in the community. So the students actually all went out together and visited some different households and donated meat to different people in the community.
The exchange with Effie Kokrine was really good. Those girls, they were really respectful. They followed direction well, and I thought it was great to have other students that don't experience the same stuff that our students might, you know, to come here and actually see it and to take part in the activities that happened that week. I think that was great because it kind of pulled people together and taught the kids how to work together. We were working on book work, but they were learning valuable skills of, you know, cooperation and cutting up meat, even though they were cutting up the meat off of every single bone. But, you know, even sharing the stuff, having to deliver the meat to the elders, that was really good.
When we went to give out the some caribou meat, I got to talk to some elders, and they were really, like, happy to see us, you know, give them some meat and have time to do that for them. So yeah, I felt happy that we kind of made them happy.